Good morning, Grace Life. I'm so glad that I have this opportunity this morning to take us away in part two of our series, I'll Do It Tomorrow, Finding the Power of Change. But before we start this morning, I just want to say today is going to be a good day. It is going to be a day that is full of new and wonderful possibilities. Change is coming. I declare this in the mighty, mighty name of Jesus. Recently, I was browsing on Facebook and I came across this caption and I just wanted to share it with someone this morning. I just really feel that this is going to touch someone's heart. It says, how cool is it that the same God who created the oceans, the galaxies and the mountains looked at you. Yes, God looked at you and said, the world needs one of you. So friend, wherever you might find yourself today, or what you're going through, or you might be questioning your significance and why are you even on this planet? Because God needed you to be in the world, to reveal to someone today just how special they are, how special you are. As I'm standing in front of this camera, it made me just think about how I can't see any of yous this morning, but all of yous can see me. And again, I just felt this is for someone this morning, that maybe you just feeling, when you look at your situation, your circumstances, you can't see God. You can't see Him. And you've been crying out for Him. But just like how you can all see me this morning, friend, I want to tell you that God sees you. He sees you. He knows you. He knows exactly where you are this morning. Don't give up. Don't give up. So I mentioned we are in part two of this amazing series, I'll Do It Tomorrow, Finding the Power of Change. And this morning, I'm going to concentrate around three words: change, sanctification, growth, and those are the three words. So, big point number one: what needs to change will draw you closer to God. All of us online today, in some part or in another area of our life, is looking for change. Here's a question that I want to ask you this morning. Who wants change in their life? Now, what if I tell you that I've been asking this question incorrectly? So let me rephrase it for you this morning. Who needs change in their life? See, friends, when we get this, things start to change. Why? Because God doesn't meet our wants. He meets our needs and knows exactly what we need and what is best for us in this season. Friend, whatever you are facing right now, wherever you may be, the decisions you have to make, the things that you're putting off for tomorrow, God knows your need and He knows exactly where you are. Philippians 4 verse 19 says, and my God will meet all your needs according to the riches of His glory in Christ Jesus. So I just want to share a quick example of what I'm speaking about this morning. Is just think about how if you're in a position, say your work isn't going well, you're having personality issues and personality clashes with employees. Maybe you haven't got the promotion or the increase you feel you deserve. Maybe you're in a position where you just feel that there's no one of authority making the right decisions and it's just like everything is all over the place. And you're just feeling very uneasy in your heart and there's just something about your situation at work that is just not sitting well with you. Now you want to find a new job because you're unhappy. What if you are exactly where you need to be so that God can do what He needs to do in order to bring the change that needs to take place? Quite often, what needs to change, friend, will draw us closer to God. Where what we want to change, the wants of our life, can sometimes take us further away from Him. See, friends, I'm just getting a real sense that God wants to deal with the conditions of our hearts this morning. He wants to see our hearts change. I'm often reminded when I just think about my own heart and the things that I've got to deal with, that God is more interested in my heart changing through the trials and tribulations that stand in front of me, rather than the situation changing and then my heart changes. See, friends, why? Because when our heart is changing through what we're facing in life, and we're trusting God, and we're reaching out to God, we are building our character. We are being molded to how God wants us to be. And when the change comes, it's everlasting. Let your heart be touched by God this morning. Again, I'll do it tomorrow, finding the power to change. And just the word reconciliation comes to mind. Maybe you are sitting on the other side of this message this morning, knowing that there's a phone call that you need to make to a loved one. Maybe to say sorry. Maybe just to break the ice of having a conversation with them, just to change what is taking place. I want to encourage you today. Pick up the phone. Give that person a call. Don't wait for tomorrow. Big point number two is our lives as believers are about changing to become more like Jesus through the process of sanctification. Friends, sanctification is our growth in God as we become more like Jesus. Sanctification is the action of making or declaring something holy. Sanctification is the action or the process of being freed from sin or purified. And again, friend, I can't stress this enough with you this morning, that sin is ultimately unbelief. It is those arguments that store up in our minds, the doubt that fills up in our hearts and takes root, that opposes God's word and opposes God's will. Friend, I want to encourage you this morning, if there's things that you're hoping to see fall off your life, I want to encourage you, get your mind and your heart right before God. Get it right before God. Trust Him. Trust Him. Build your faith. And I promise you, the very things that you want to see shed off your life, as your mind and your heart and your faith starts to align with the perfect will of God, the very things that you want to see fall off you start to fall away, because we're becoming more like Jesus. I just want to encourage you this morning. Before you do anything in life, choose to go after Jesus. He is our Lord and Savior. He is the one that makes everything change in our lives. The term for sanctification used in the New Covenant basically means set apart, in the sense of being set apart from all else and dedicated for God's use. We can allow the distractions of life, the distractions to come in, pull us off the very thing that God wants to do in us today, the very thing He wants to use us for. Don't allow anything to stand in your calling today. I can't stress this enough. We have such destiny in God. He loves us so much. He cares about us so much, and He wants you and I to feel and experience His presence and everything that He has for us. And it starts today. We don't have to put it off tomorrow. There's nothing in your life that disqualifies you when you start to make yourself available for Christ, and you start to be obedient to the call on your life, and you step out to trust Him. Let that be today. in 1 Peter 2 verse 9, it says, "But you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's special possession." I feel again, there's someone on you that needs to know that you are God's special possession. When He looks at you, He sees you are my special possession. "That you may declare the praises of Him who called you out of darkness into His wonderful light." Colossians 3 verse 1 to 3 says, "Since then you have been raised with Christ, set your heart," friends, we're back to the condition of our hearts, "set our hearts on things above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things above, not on the earthly things that are around us. For you died and your life is now hidden." Friends, that word "hidden" is kept out of sight, concealed. Your life is concealed. Your life is hidden in Christ, in God. Isn't that amazing? Sanctification begins when we come to faith in Christ and God sets us apart as His children. 1 Corinthians 6 verse 11 says, tells us, "We are washed, we were sanctified, we were justified by Jesus and by the Spirit of God." See, friend, God continues to transform His children, you and I, from the inside out. He who started a good work in you will see it to completion. That is a promise over your life. So wherever you find yourself today, nothing is going to disqualify you from the truth and the reality that He who started a good work in you will see it to completion. Friend, our response is to respond to that promise and say, "Lord, I'm here today. Speak to me. Bring the conviction into my heart that you want to deal with today so I can make the decision today that I don't have to wait tomorrow." One act of obedience, friend, can radically change your destiny, can radically change your life. The Holy Spirit is always talking to us. So allow the Holy Spirit to talk to you today and then respond by faith. And I promise you, you will not be disappointed. Why is He changing us from the inside out? So that you and I become more like Jesus, to reflect Jesus to the world more and more. Friends, we are set apart from the world, from darkness, set, placed to be used in His wonderful light, in His kingdom. Isn't that amazing? That the Creator of heaven and earth wants to use you in His kingdom. He wants you to reveal His light to every person and everyone around us. I think that is absolutely amazing. See, friends, God is the change. God is our change. We are sons and daughters of the Most High God. But we are also warriors in His kingdom. Again, there are battles for us to fight today that God is asking us not to put off till tomorrow. He has full confidence in His ability in us, that when we trust Him and we step out and we say we are here today to enter the battlefield, to step into the arena of faith, and we're going to trust God with the battles that He wants us to fight today, to see the change that He wants to see in our lives. God is not the big ogre. He's not the one that comes to kill, rob, and destroy. God brings life. Life comes through change. God brings liberation and freedom. Liberation and freedom comes through change as we trust Him, that He knows better and He knows what we need now. And we respond to Him by faith. We respond by trusting Him. We respond by just seeking after Him. We respond by taking that chance. Faith is ultimately chance. We take that chance to trust God and make the decisions that He's asking us to make today instead of holding off and waiting for tomorrow. God loves you. He cares about you. He knows that when you start to rely and trust on Him and you operate by faith, the sky is the limit. Point number three, we're going into point number three. Will we allow our lives to be changed to reflect Jesus? And it's going to take some effort. Sportsmen and women know the saying, no pain, no gain. This phrase, no pain, no gain, stresses the idea that growth comes about painfully through hard work and sacrifice. Think about if you of late have gone for a road run or you've been to the gym. It takes a lot of effort and energy to accomplish a workout. And afterwards, you're not just all, you can go again. You've tired and your legs are sore and your arms are sore. And you actually then need to sometimes like go have a rest or have a big sip of water or maybe a good meal just to revive your body. See friends, this is true. This is true for physical growth. But the same can be said about growing as a son and daughter in the kingdom to reflect Jesus. Think about someone who has been in a tragic accident. Maybe you know someone. And they have to learn how to walk all over again. Relearning how to walk can not only physically be painful. Just think about it, that their muscles haven't been working for such a long time and now that they're trying to work. Just think about the pain they must be feeling. But also the mental stress that they must be going through. And you might say mental stress. Yes. Why? Because during the physical therapy, they struggle because they are learning something they thought they already knew all over again. Let's just take 10 seconds. Just think about waking up this morning and not being able to get out of bed and just walk. Knowing in your mind that you know how to walk, but you can't do it. I wouldn't like to feel that at all. But sometimes, friends, we can struggle in our walk with God. There can be stuff God is highlighting to us that we need to deal with, which can be painful. And we don't want to feel that pain. And you know what? The first instant, we just want to push the pain to the side. We'll leave you over here and we'll carry on walking because it feels so much better. But it's such a lie and a robbery from the enemy, friend. Why? Because the very thing that God is trying to put in front of you, that pain that you don't want to deal with, and He's putting it there in front of you so that you can deal with it. Because God knows that when you start to deal with the pain that is causing you to step back from Him, when we deal with it and there's breakthrough and change that comes, there's liberation and freedom, all of a sudden we didn't even know what existed in that spacious place of freedom and peace in our hearts, because we've never ever dealt with it. And when we deal with it, not pushing it away, deal with it and walk through it, and there's healing and change comes in our hearts. There's a spacious place that we walk into, and we realize that only God can give that spacious place. We need to deal with the pain in our life. We can't run away from it. It will hamper us forever and ever until we deal with it. And it's not to make us feel worse, it's to bring us, I'm going to mention that again, it's to bring us into that spacious place. There can be stuff God has, I've already read that, so I'm not going to read that again. Or maybe it just feels like it's too much hard work and that the sacrifice is too great. Or maybe you're finding yourself having to learn things that you thought you already knew, and it comes up against everything that you've ever believed in. And now that you've got to try and navigate through this the battlefield of the mind, trying to align your mind with God's word, but you've always thought that things were this way. But now you've got to be humble and say, you know, I'm going to trust God in this process, that His way is higher than my way, and I can trust where He's leading me down this road. But this is the encouragement, friend. Change and growth doesn't happen in an instant. There is no microwave spirituality, which means that growth takes time. Yes, it takes time. And I'm not now trying to contradict myself or tell you just to take your foot off the wagon. No, there's a process that starts to take place. And the most important thing that we do as we wait for time is to get on mission to know Jesus, to actively seek Him out whilst we continue to walk life with Him. God says in James 4 verse 8, draw near to me and I will draw near to you. That's amazing. I just want to share another example with you. Fast food versus a lekker South African cooked meal. Fast food is quick and will temporarily fill your stomach. And sometimes they're quite tasty too. But it's highly processed, unhealthy, and can be expensive. But on the other hand, a lekker South African home-cooked meal in the oven or a slow cooker gives the food time to marinate and absorb all the flavors. Yes, it takes more time, more effort. Yes, you're gonna have to put some time aside to start all the preparation and watch the process of this home-cooked meal take place. And there's gonna be more frustration. Yes, frustration. But in the end, it is so worth it. It is so worth it. Our walk with God, friends, isn't a sprint or a quick fix to happiness, but it's a lifetime of drawing close to our Father, crying out, Abba Father, every day of our lives. Our lifelong journey with the Lord is going to be tough at times, messy some of the times, hard at other times. But what I've been learning and what has been spoken into my life, that when we keep on mission of building our relationship with Jesus, with God, through the Holy Spirit, where I was 5 years ago to where I stand today, there has been so much growth. There's been change. Yes, there's been some hard times along the way, but I've continuously moved forward. And if you continue on mission with Jesus, 5 years from now, you're gonna be further in your walk. There's gonna be more growth and more change. Isn't that just amazing? So don't wait for tomorrow. Today is the day to choose God, to trust in God. Trust Him with the decisions that you need to make today. We continue to allow the Holy Spirit to do the work He can only do in our lives. Today, if you hear His voice, the voice of the Holy Spirit, do not harden your heart. Rather, reach out, respond, trust Him, knowing that He only wants the best for you, that there's things that need to be sorted out in our hearts, in our minds, and in our lives. And we get on mission today, tomorrow will be an amazing opportunity to take something else on. Romans 8 verse 11 says, the same Spirit who raised Christ from the dead lives inside every believer. That is our confidence, hope, knowing that the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of God who raised Christ from the dead, now lives in us. And that should give us all the confidence and guile in the world to stand strong, steadfast, making the changes that we need to make today. Today, you have His Spirit. You don't have to wait for tomorrow to do the things God is asking you to do today. Through Him, we can change. And that is just such an encouragement. When I read that out to my, when I read it out now, it just encourages me. I'm going to read it one more time. Today, you have His Spirit. You don't have to wait for tomorrow to do the things God is asking us to do today. Through Him, through Jesus, through going into the presence of God, through the Holy Spirit in us, we can change and see the change that we desire in our lives. So I just want to end off this morning and leave you with some handles today that have been so helpful and important in my life over the last 5 years or so. And I will continue to carry this for the next 5 years, going into the next decade, because they are very important and help. The first one, prayer. Prayer is our lifeline to God. We must be actively speaking to God all the time. Number two, His Word. We need to be in it as much as possible. Friends, this is just my understanding of it. If I only know 10 promises in the Bible, I'm only going to respond and live my faith by those 10 promises. If I know 1,000, it's going to go to 1,000. So the more we know of the Bible, the more we are building our relationship through His Word, the stronger our faith comes. Hearing, faith comes from hearing and reading, I believe. Be on mission, no matter what you're facing, no matter how tough life may seem, be on mission to build your relationship with Jesus. Be about God's business as much as you can. For me, that's just life groups. It's about a Thursday night prayer meeting. It's about a Sunday morning. It's ultimately about community and being connected to the community that I'm in. It's about having brothers and sisters around me, like-minded, faithful people in my life. And then the main one for me is have someone in your life that you are prepared to learn to trust, learn to trust, and open your heart to their counsel. So friends, I just want to say thank you so much for listening to this message this morning. I just trust that it's encouraged you, knowing that the Holy Spirit is working continuously in you to bring the change that you desire in your life. I just want to say again that I just trust that there's going to be revelation, wisdom, there's going to be a steadfast, a confidence just to stand up and make the decisions that God is calling you to make today. I just want to again just thank everyone that is online, to everyone that has made this morning happen. It is absolutely amazing. You guys are an absolute blessing. From me to you, we will see you soon.